But right now, Clayton is joining Kelly Tennant and Ned Colletti live on our set at Dodger Stadium.
Speaking of all-stars, there's an all-star pitcher tonight, Alex Wood.
Yeah.
You're a student of the game. You know how pitching goes. What have you seen different from him, if anything, this year than last year? Any one thing that stands out?
Well, anytime you're on this type of run, I feel like the consistency has to be there every single night. And so, you know, every fifth day, it seems like Woody brings the exact same stuff to the mound.
Getting three runs was a great start. Giving up four the next inning was not.
At that moment in that game, when you think about how tough it is to score runs, and we had scored two, and we had a couple other opportunities, not being able to cash them. When the opponent can steal a run like that, taking a walk and going first to third on a walk and then having a sack fly. You work so hard for your runs, and then you give back half of what you got just like that. Momentum changer.
The draft process offers an unpredictable, precarious path. Not only do you have to love a player, the teams who pick in front of you need to love somebody just a little bit more. We picked seventh. We needed six other players to be called who weren't named Kershaw. When one looks back on that draft, they will find three of the greatest pitchers of a decade picked within five spots of each other. At 11, Arizona selected Max Scherzer, a Cy Young Award winner with two no-hitters. At 10, San Francisco selected Tim Lincecum, two Cy Young Awards, three World Championships, and two no-hitters. And at 7, the best of them all, Clayton Kershaw, with three Cy Young Awards and an MVP.
You and this team kind of sit in a unique place right now. 48 games over, massive lead over the second place team. What do you look for in the last 48 games? Is there things you focus in? One or two game lead or one or two game deficit would be a different look. What are you focusing on?
It's a good question. We actually spent some time talking about it a little bit in Arizona, and it's not to take away from the focus of, you know, grinding through each game and that mindset.
He had, like we said the other night, he had very few bad innings, let alone games. And when you talk about a full season, 220-some innings, and you can pick out a few, you can remember a few bad innings for a starting pitcher, that's remarkable. And you talk about WHIP. In the history of baseball, going back 140 years, whatever it is, there's been 11 pitchers that have had a WHIP lower than he for a season. 11 out of how many thousands?
When you have a hitter down 0-2, it used to always bug me a little bit when you had somebody down 0-2, and you're able to not get him out, and he ends up hitting a home run on an 0-2 pitch. When you're 0-2 and you're a pitcher, you've got all sorts of leeway, I always believe. You can, in his case, use a changeup, use a cutter. You've got all different ways you can go to keep the ball off the plate.
A lot of work goes on right now, a lot of scouting, a lot of back work goes on to really scout, make sure you know the inside and out of the other organizations you're talking to, because there may be a minor league player prospect that is going to be also involved in it. And it's also important to know your own guys very well.
When you get back this year, what do you think the toughest adjustment will be? Timing, speed of game?
I definitely the speed of game. Timing, I like to say knock on wood, has always been one of the easier things that's come back to me. It's just getting used to the speed of the game, the quickness of it.
Everybody pitched great. Frias was really good. One bad pitch early to Goldschmidt. He's not the first Dodger to give up a home run to Goldschmidt.
Exactly.
The only one today, but not the first. After that, though, the bullpen really kind of rescued the group, and the offense hung in there until they could get it going in the eighth. The year that he had, he gets left behind a little bit because you're talking about Jack a lot, you're talking about Jake a lot. Clayton Kershaw, in any other year, he's going to win the Cy Young Award. You had one of those years where you had three really upper echelon guys that really kind of split the vote, and two happened to be on one team. We have been talking about a number of players, including Kenley Jansen, about possible position changes. At the All-Star break in 2009, Deshaun Watson came to me and he said, Kenley Jansen, we're running out of time with him. We're going to have to make a decision when we get to November about whether or not to put him on the 40-man roster or expose him to the Rule 5 draft, which means every team in baseball could claim him at that year's winter meetings.
I hear you are useful, though. I hear that you've been great with a lot of the young guys on this team. And as a veteran, as a senior guy here, you've taken on some leadership and you've taken on some conversations. I mean, I hear it all the time, but you've been a big positive in that room.
Well, thank you. You know, it's one word. You try to make the most of your situation. And in my situation, this is what I've been dealt.
Something else is how you start the second half. Because sometimes when you've been playing hard, you take a little bit of a breath for those 4 days, and it takes you a little while to get moving. Very important. Dodgers come out strong tonight and set the tone going forward.
Can you open the door a little bit and tell us if you're going to bring up any big right-handed pitchers that went to Vanderbilt, maybe for September, maybe?
With the initials WB, maybe? Yeah, I mean, this is all part of the plan at the beginning of the season. It's his first full year back from Tommy John.
Won a World Series ring in 2009 with the Yankees. And then somehow he showed up with a weapon and a mask and got Ned to sign him for 2 years.
Turn me into a broadcaster.
Grounds out to shorts.
What did he tell Nomar one time, that they were the same kind of hitter? Nomar just got better pitches?
Yeah, that's exactly what he says.